Back a little bit. Hallelujah. Gotta hear that a little bit more, just a little bit more. Just a little bit more before we get started on tonight. Just begin to worship God in that space. Lord, I belong to you. Where would I be, God?
I don't know. I just don't know.
Where would I be without you?
Oh, Bobby, you can stay right here.
How could I live without you?
Thank you, God. My God, we thank you.
I'd be so lost without you.
So lost without you. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Where would I be
without you? That's just in my spirit at this moment, God. Where would I be without you? Thank you, Lord.
Where would I be
I be
without you? How could I live? How could I live without you?
Come on, say it.
Where would I be without you?
It's all in.
Someone that's raising up, say, where would I be?
Where would I be?
Where would I
be? Thank you, Lord, for being on me.
Without you. Come on, raise that up, say, where would I be?
Where would I be without the Lord? Where would you be without the Lord? Glory be to God. Our God is so worthy. And tonight, I simply say, God, do whatever you want to do in this space. God knows each and every one of us that are on here. He knows where we are. And I walk with him, and he knows exactly what we need. But more than that, he knows what he wants from us on tonight. And so I've come on here tonight with no agenda but to worship him. Right? God, do whatever you want to do in this moment. And so thank you. I feel like every time I come on here, my sinuses start to drain. But thank you for joining us once again for Daybreak Women. Thursday night equip. The goal of Daybreak Woman is to fuel you, to charge you, to get you so pumped, to get you so motivated that you would walk into the very things that God has for you to do. But more than that, that you would experience what it means to have his abundant life on the inside of you. That you would know what it means to live abundantly for the Lord living in you, him abiding in you, and you abiding in him. You living in his presence, dwelling in his presence, and encountering him anew every single day. And so let's just go into worship. We're already there, but let's stay there. Let's go a little further. My God, we bless you. God, we honor you. Oh, we honor you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, God. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. Can you just give the Lord a thanksgiving right where you are? Just give him a thanksgiving on tonight. God bless you. Give him a thanksgiving. Give him a thanksgiving. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you. Where would we be without you, God? We would be lost. We wouldn't be here, God, but we would be lost. We would be lost. Lost in our mess, lost in our sin, lost in our misery, lost in depression, lost in sorrow, lost in sadness, lost in our mess. We would be lost. Oh, God, but we thank you tonight, Lord, that you found us, that you came after us, God, and that you pulled us out of the darkness that we were in. God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, God, that you are acquainted, oh God, with every single one of our ways. God, we thank you, Lord Jesus, that you never leave us, God, that you never forsake us. God, we honor you. We honor your great name. We honor your presence. We honor you, Lord. We honor you, amazing one. We honor you, King. We honor you, Master. We honor you, Savior, God. We honor you. We honor you. We honor you, Lord. Oh, God, we honor you. Oh, God, we bless you. Come on, stay there in God's presence. Keep giving him praise. Keep praising him right in that space, right in that space. Glory be to your name, God. Right in that space. Come on, let's stay right there just a little bit longer. Oh, God, we bless you. We worship you. God, we are who we are because of you. We have what we have because of you. We are where we are, God, because of you. We're still standing in this moment, God, because of you. Come on, we have so much to be grateful for tonight. We have so much to be grateful for, so many trials, so many various things that you have gone through, but you are still standing. Ah, come on, praise God that you are still standing. Praise God that thing didn't take you out, that it threatened to take you out, but it didn't. You're still here. God, we bless you. We honor you in this place. We honor your sweet presence, God. We bless you. We're still here. We're still here to worship you, God. We're still here to magnify you. We're still here to honor you. We're still here to love on you, God. We're still here and we're so grateful. We're so grateful. We're grateful. We're grateful. Come on, shower the Lord with your gratefulness wherever you are in this moment. Let's just press, oh God, in this moment. Shower him with your thanksgiving. Shower him with your gratitude. Shower him with your appreciation. Shower him on this night. We bless you, God. We thank you. 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 We thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, God, we bless your name. Oh, God, we honor your name. You're wonderful, God. You're wonderful. You're powerful. As we're in God's presence, I want to read the Gospel of John, the 5th chapter. And let the word of the Lord just shower you on tonight. And I'm reading out of the New International Version. John 5. Sometime later, Jesus went up to Jerusalem for one of the Jewish festivals. Now there is in Jerusalem near the Sheep Gate a pool, which in Aramaic is called Bethesda, and which is surrounded by 5 covered colonnades. Here a great number of disabled people used to lie: the blind, the lame, the paralyzed. One who was there had been an invalid for 38 years. When Jesus saw him lying there and learned that he had been in this condition for a long time, he asked him, "Do you want to get well?" "Sir," the invalid replied, "I have no one to help me into the pool when the water is stirred. While I am trying to get in, someone else goes down ahead of me." Then Jesus said to him, "Get up, pick up your mat and walk." At once the man was cured. He picked up his mat and walked. The day on which this took place was a Sabbath. And so the Jewish leader said to the man who had been healed, "It is the Sabbath. The law forbids you to carry your mat." But he replied, "The man who made me well said to me, 'Pick up your mat and walk.'" So they asked him, "Who is this fellow who told you to pick it up and walk?" The man who was healed had no idea who it was, for Jesus had slipped away into the crowd that was there. Later, Jesus found him at the temple and said to him, "See, you are well again. Stop sinning, or something worse may happen to you." The man went away and told the Jewish leaders that it was Jesus who made him well. It was Jesus who made him well. It was Jesus who made him well. And tonight, I believe the Lord just wants us, just like that man, to come to the pool, to come to the waters, to receive whatever healing that we stand in need of. Whether it's physical, whether it's emotional, whether it's just things that's been on your mind, whatever the healing is, whether it's your heart, whatever it is, the Lord just wants us to present ourselves in a position that we might receive whatever we need from him. This man was at this pool, near the pool, and years had gone by, and he never was able to get in because of his situation. He couldn't get into the pool that was stirred every year. But on this particular year, he didn't have to go to the pool physically, but Jesus, the bread of life, came to him. Jesus, the healer, came to him. Jesus, the savior, came to him. Jesus, the redeemer, came to him. Jesus, the reconciler, came to him and said to him, "Do you want to be made well?" The man proceeded to tell him how long he's been waiting, and many of us would proceed to tell the Lord how long we've been going through what we've been going through, how long we've been facing what we've been facing, how long we've been feeling the way we've been feeling, how long we've been encountering the very things we've been encountering. But the word of the Lord comes to us in response to that which we are going through, and the Lord says, "Take up our bed and walk." Oh my God, healer is here. The healer is here. And so tonight, I know it's a little different for our Thursday nights, but just open your heart to, would you receive Jesus the healer? Would you receive Jesus the one that is able to take whatever your heart is feeling and give you peace? Who is able to take whatever's on your mind and settle you in that place? Who's able to take the sickness, the pain, the agony, the heartbreak, whatever it is that is bothering you, that is like a torment in your soul, whatever it is, and receive his peace on tonight? And so just open your heart to receive from him. Oh, God, we thank you. My God, we thank you. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you for your presence. And God, I ask, oh Lord, that your presence would just overtake each and every one of us, God, that your presence would flood our homes. Your presence would flood our hearts. Your presence, God, would flood our minds. Your presence, God, would overtake the very environment that we are in. God, that the place we are in, God, it would turn, it would be transformed, God, into your sanctuary, God, into your dwelling place. God, we pray in the name of Jesus, God, that there would be just such a strong outpour of your spirit. God, that we, Lord, wouldn't be able to continue doing just the things that may be distracting us in this moment. But God, we would stop in your presence. And God, that we, Lord, would just make space for you. God, that we would just make room for you. And so, God, we pray even now in the mighty name of Jesus, God, that you would remove the weights that have been weighing us down. God, the various things, God, that we've been walking with, the various things, God, that have been on our shoulder. God, the various things that have been stressing us. God, the various things that have been wearing us out. God, the various things, God, that are trying us. God, we pray in the name of Jesus, God, that you would break that thing on this morning, God, this night, God, that sorrow would be broken in Jesus' name. God, that sadness and depression be broken in Jesus' name. God, we thank you that in your presence, there is fullness of joy, and at your right hand, God, there are pleasures forevermore. And so, God, we say, overtake us in your presence, my God. Overtake us in your presence. Overtake us in your presence. Overtake us in your presence. God, we thank you, Lord. God, we thank you that the hardness, God, that some of us have been feeling is broken, oh God, in your presence. God, we thank you even now, God, that as some are shedding tears, God, the frustration is being washed away, God, in your presence. God, we thank you. And God, we thank you that those, God, who are weary in their bodies, God, weary in their circumstances, weary from waiting, God, we thank you. Oh God, that you are renewing their strength even now. God, we thank you that you are refreshing. God, that you are sending a refreshing wind upon your people. You are sending a refreshing, oh God. God, those who've been going through after going through, it seems like, God, something is always coming against them. God, it seems like something is always rising up in their life, God. They think they'll get up here, but then next thing that happens, the situation brings them back down. God, I thank you that right now, Lord, God, that you are renewing them. I thank you, God, that you are refreshing them, God. God, I thank you that you are raining on the fields of our hearts. God, that you are pouring, oh God, on our hearts. God, I thank you, Lord, that you are showering, oh God, us with your presence. God, you are showering us with your presence, God. God, there are some who are on here right now, and some who will tune in, God, and look at the replay. And God, there will be those, oh God, since last year who have suffered loss after loss. God, they've lost people. God, they've lost things. God, they've lost relationships. God, they've lost jobs. God, they've lost so much. But God, I thank you that you are a restorer. And God, I intercede on their behalf right now in the name of Jesus. God, that you, the restorer, would restore all that concerns them. God, that you would perfect every single thing that concerns them, God. God, the person that cries out and says, Lord, I can't take anymore, how much more? Oh, God, I pray that you would step into their circumstance, God. Oh, God, and that you, Lord, would turn things around on their behalf. God, that you would work on their behalf, God. God, that you would cause miracles, God, to show up in their lives. God, those who've been waiting for open doors, and it seems like door after door is closing in their face. God, I thank you, Lord, for opening doors. God, I thank you for your favor upon their lives, God. I thank you, Lord, and I speak your word over them, God, that goodness and mercy will follow them all the days of their lives, and they will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. God, I pray for those who dealt with so much hurt, and God, that hurt has them in a place of stagnation. God, I thank you that you are the one that heals every single wound. God, you are the one that is acquainted with all of our sorrows. There's not one thing that happens to us that you're not aware of. And so, God, I pray for those individuals right now, God. And God, that you, Lord, would heal. God, that you would transform. God, that you, Lord, would do a work in their hearts, God, as only you can do. God, you heal. God, do a deep work. God, we're not asking for a shallow healing. We're not asking, God, for just a temporary healing. But God, we're asking, Lord, that you would do a deep work. God, that you would do a deep work that would remain, God. God, just like that man who was at that pool waiting, oh God, for his chance to get in. God, there are those who are waiting, oh God, for their turn for a miracle. There are those who are waiting for their turn for a breakthrough. There are those, God, who are waiting for their turn for a miracle. But God, we cry out right now in the name of Jesus, God, that you would move on behalf of them, God. Thank you, Lord. God, there is so much agony in this world. God, there is so much pain. I'm even reminded in this moment, God, your spirit is reminding me, God, even to pray, Lord, for those in Florida, God. God, those who've lost loved ones, God, in the falling of that building. God, we pray for the comfort of your Holy Spirit. We pray, oh God, that you would comfort grieving hearts. God, that you would give them peace in the midst of this tragedy. God, that you would show up, oh God, in somehow, some way, God. God, that you would turn, oh God, that you would just cause for joy to come in their hearts. You would cause for laughter. God, there's so much heaviness. God, there's so much sorrow. God, there's so much sadness, but God, that you will cause, Lord, for transformation in the hearts of those who are hurting. God, there are some families that have lost multiple loved ones. God, there are some families, God, where a whole household has been swept away. But God, even in that situation, you are a God that can heal. Even in that situation, you are a God that can bring comfort. God, even in that situation, God, you, oh God, could do a work in their heart. And so we pray, Holy Spirit, that you would give them everything they need in this moment. You would give them everything they need in this moment, oh God. For that mother who is burying a child, give her everything that she needs. For that father who is burying a child, give him everything that he needs. For those who lost parents, God, give them everything that they need. For those who've lost spouses, give them everything that they need. God, we pray that you would rise up, oh God, with healing in your hands. And God, that you would touch every grieving heart. God, touch. God, touch. God, touch. You're able to comfort in ways that we cannot. You're able, God, to mend in ways that we cannot. God, you're able to do things, oh God, that we're not able to do. And so, God, we pray that you would reach every grieving heart, that you would reach, oh God, every hurting heart, God, do a work, God. Do a work, God, do a work, do a work, God. My God, we even cry out, God, for what's happening in Haiti even now, Lord. We say, send your healing touch to that land. Send your healing touch, oh God. Send your healing touch. Send your healing touch, God. Touch, 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 God. Oh God, we honor you. We bring, oh God, the nation of Haiti, oh God, and we place it in your hands. God, we pray, Lord, that you will cause transformation to come. That you will cause change to come. That you will cause deliverance to come. That you will cause revival to come. That you will cause healing to come. You will cause salvation, oh God, to break out in that land, oh God, in the name of Jesus. God, we cry out for revival. We cry out, God, for revival. We cry out for revival in the name of Jesus. God, we pray that you comfort the family of the president of Haiti that was assassinated. Comfort, God. We pray, Lord, that you touch his wife, heal, God. We pray, God, that you touch that entire family. That you touch, God. We pray that you bring peace. God, that you bring resolution. God, that you bring transformation. God, that you do a work in that land in the name of Jesus. God, we praise you. Across this nation, God, across the world, God, do a work, God, out of our soul. God, we cry out that you would render the heavens, oh God, and that you would pour out healing on this land. Healing on us individually, but healing, oh God, on this land. Healing in this world, God. Healing in our communities. God, healing in our cities. God, healing in our homes. God, healing in our churches. God, we pray that you would send healing. Whatever needs to be healed, that you would heal it. Whatever needs to be touched, God, that you would touch it. God, we cry out to you tonight, the one that heals, the one that sets things in order. God, the one that upsets the plans of the enemy. The one, oh God, that uproots the structure. option, oh God. The one, oh God, that can cause the weapons of the enemy to be null and void. You are the God that can do it. And so comfort, God. Comfort, oh God, we cry out comfort. We cry out comfort of your Holy Spirit. We cry out comfort of your Holy Spirit. Thank you, God, that you would comfort, oh God, comfort. That healing, we know so many people, God, that are sick, we ask that you heal. We know so many, God, that are sick, we ask that you heal in the name of Jesus. We ask, oh God, that you send your healing power, God. There are so many, God, that know you, God, who are calling on you for healing. God, there are so many that are dealing with all the diseases that are known to man. But God, you are greater than every disease. You are greater than every sickness. You are greater than every illness. God, you are the cure that we need. And so, God, we say cure, oh God. We say heal, God. Deliver, God, in the name of Jesus. Send your healing. Heal from all sickness. Heal from all infirmity. Deliver, heal, deliver, and set free. Oh, God, heal. Heal, heal, heal. Come on, we're crying out tonight for healing. We're crying out for healing. We're crying out for healing in this atmosphere. You know, anyone that needs to be healed, just write out, write their name in the chat. Come on, let's call their name out. God knows your writing. He knows your chatting. Just put it in the chat. Call it. What's your name? Put your name in the chat. If there's someone you know, put their name there. We're crying out and we're believing God for healing. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. My God, we bless you. Oh, God, we bless your name. We bless your name. We bless your name, God. Oh, God, I see those names coming in. We thank you, God. We thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you, God. We thank you. We thank you, God, for healing Katina Gordon. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, for healing Minister Rhonda. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, God, for healing Elder Lorraine. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, for healing Pat. We thank you. We thank you for healing LaShawna Brown. We thank you, God. We thank you for healing Desiree, God. We thank you. We thank you for healing Sister Iris. We thank you, God. Oh, I thank you, God, for healing Reverend Melvin Wilson. We thank you, God. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, God. Oh, come on, let's throw out names on tonight. Let's throw out names. Come on, let's throw out names. We thank you, God, for healing Sister Sally. We thank you, God. We thank you, Lord, for healing Shayna. We thank you, God. Oh, we thank you, God, for healing Pastor Mary. God, we thank you. Oh, God, we thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you. We thank you, God. Oh, glory be to your name. Glory be to your name. We thank you, God, for healing Brother Cameron Green. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for healing Sister Caridad. We thank you, God. We thank you, Lord, for being a healer. You are the God that heals. You are the God that heals. You are the God that heals. We thank you for healing Sharonda. We thank you for healing her heart. God, we thank you for doing it. We thank you for healing Pastor Mercedes, God. We thank you, God, for healing. We thank you. We thank you for healing, God. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you, God. We thank you. Hey, come on. You know some more people. Throw their names out. We're thanking God for healing. And as we're thanking God for their healing, we are praying for them. Oh, God, we bless you. Oh, thank you, God, for healing Minister Greg Brown. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, God, for healing Charlene. Come on, we're not just talking about physical healing, but some people need to get emotional healing as well. There's some people that are disconnected. Their hearts are grieving, and they need healing. They need the healing touch of the Father. Oh, yeah. There's so many people who are disappointed, and it's pushed them away from the Lord. They need to be healed. Their hearts need to be healed. Their hearts need to be restored. Thank you, Lord God. We believe that God attends to the cries of his people. We pray for Zion. Thank you, Lord, for healing. We thank you for Zayna. We thank you for healing, God. We thank you for Bernadette for healing. We thank you, God, for Isaiah for healing. Oh, God, we thank you. We thank you for healing Michael, God. We thank you, Lord. Oh, we thank you for healing Beautiful. We thank you for healing Judah. That's right. Put your children out there. Come on. We thank you, God, for healing Jermaine Jr. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Thank you, God. I thank you, Lord, for healing me. Come on, you can put your own name out there. Thank you, Lord, for healing Jermaine Sr. We thank you, God, for healing. We thank you for healing. God, even those who are watching who were not on the live, God, we thank you for healing them. We thank you, oh my God, we thank you for healing. We thank you, God, that even as this prayer is going forth, oh God, that healing is taking place in the lives of your people, that transformation is coming in the lives of your people, God, that chains are being broken, oh God, where there has not been breakthrough before, there is breakthrough now in Jesus' name. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. We thank you, Lord Jesus. We thank you for healing Miriam. We thank you, God, for healing Zuri. We thank you, God, for healing Simone. We thank you, Simone. We thank you, God, for healing John. We thank you, Lord, for healing Alicia. Oh, God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord Jesus. We bless you. Oh, hey, God, you are the healer. You are the healer, you are the healer, you are the healer, and we worship you. We worship you, we worship you, we worship you, we worship you. Thank you, God, for healing Florence. God, we thank you, we thank you. You are the healer. Heal everything concerning these individuals. God, we lift them up before you, God. We give them to you. Thank you, Lord. There's even some of you. God, you've had a certain conditions. You've dealt with certain things for so long that you even stopped praying about it. You stopped believing God for it. No, you know your name out there. We thank you, God. I thank you, God, for healing Lydia. Thank you, Lord, my God. We thank you. Oh, God, thank you. There's some of you that got heart stuff, heart stuff, heart stuff. Not just physical, but in the heart, there's healing that needs to take place. There's bitterness there, and the Lord wants it. Oh, God, I thank you. Oh, God, that's right. Thank you. Thank you for healing Beatrice and her husband, John. Thank you, God. Thank you for healing Jackie Galloway. Thank you for healing Grace. Thank you for healing Christina. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. That's right, Bobby. Thank you for healing the marriages, God. We lift up even marriages before you. Every marriage represented amongst those on here now and those who will tune in. God, we thank you for healing their marriage. Oh, God, thank you. Oh, God, we thank you for healing Johnny Sr. We thank you for healing Jerome. My God, I thank you. Thank you. Yes, yeah, yeah. Thank you, God, for healing our unsaved family members. God, we thank you. Oh, God, ultimate healing. Saving their souls. God, we thank you for saving their souls, God. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, God, for leading them to you. Every single one of us, our families that are represented, you know every member of our families by name, God. We thank you, Lord, for healing. We thank you, God, for delivering. We thank you, God, for saving. We thank you, oh God, for turning their lives around. We thank you, God, for turning them back to you. God, even those who are tuning, God, who have fallen astray, who are no longer serving you, who are no longer seeking you the way that they once did. God, I thank you that healing, oh God, is coming to them right now. I thank you, oh God, that you are healing their hearts in Jesus' name. I thank you, oh God, that you are removing the bitterness, God. God, that you're removing the ugly taste that was left in their mouth, God. I thank you, oh God, that you are restoring, God. Thank you, Lord. God, I thank you. Where hearts have been hardened, God, you are now softening in Jesus' name. Oh, God, I thank you for doing it. Oh, God, I thank you. Thank you for healing Keisha, for healing Pamela, for healing Shayla, for healing Simone. God, I thank you. Yeah. Thank you for healing Sister Molly Jones and her family. We lift her up. No, God, we lift them up, God. God, we lift up all those who are depressed in this season. We lift them up, God. Lift off of them the weight of depression, God. You give beauty for ashes. Cause for the joy of the Lord to rise up in them. Cause for the joy of the Lord to be their strength. Cause for the joy of the Lord to be their portion. Cause for your joy, oh God, to rise up on the inside of them, God. Oh God, we bless you. We thank you. Thank you, God. Oh, we thank you, God, for healing Maria Carabayo. We thank you, God, for healing Brandon, for healing Gabriel, for healing Estelle. We thank you, God, for healing Maris, God, for healing Jose, for healing Zion. We thank you, God, for healing. We thank you, God, for healing Dorothy, God, for healing her bronchial tubes. God, we thank you for healing, oh God, Nancy. We thank you, God, for healing. Come on. We thank you, God, for healing. Healing is coming to your homes. Healing is coming to your hearts. Healing. Jesus showed up to the pool that man had been waiting. And Jesus showed up and he healed. He said, rise up, take up your bed and walk. And that's what we are believing for. Thank you, God. Well, we thank you for healing Erica Miller. Thank you, God. Oh, God, I thank you. I thank you, God, for healing Pastor Erica Martinez. God, I thank you for healing. Thank you for healing. Thank you for healing. Oh, God, thank you for healing Bobby. Thank you for healing. Thank you for touching. Oh, my God, I thank you. God, I thank you even for healing, God, things that have been diagnosed and even healing from things that have been undiagnosed, things that we're not getting treatment for. I thank you for healing both. God, thank you. Thank you for healing the things we're aware of and even the things that we're not aware of. Thank you, God. Thank you for healing Alexandra Flowers. I thank you for healing her, God. Thank you for healing Pastor Giselle. God, we thank you. We thank you for healing the entire Bonilla family, God. We thank you. Healing the entire Martinez family, God. We thank you. Oh, God, we bless you. We thank you for healing, oh, God. You are a healer, my God. And even when we've suffered loss, oh God, you can heal, oh God. And you can give us, oh God, a new outlook on life. You are a healer. You're a restorer. God, I speak over these individuals that all is not lost. That this is not their end. But God, just like you gave this man at the well, a new take on life, a new opportunity to live, a new day began in his life. God, I speak that over these individuals, that a new day shall begin in their lives in Jesus' name. We pray for Deborah Bacon. We pray healing in Jesus' name. I pray, oh God, healing over Cheryl Smith Oliver and her husband. I pray healing in Jesus' name. Oh God, we bless you. We bless you, God. We bless you. Healing over Mother Crump. Thank you, God, for healing. Thank you for healing her. Thank you for healing, oh God. Thank you for healing. Oh, God, I thank you. Oh, God, I thank you for healing, Reverend Diane. I thank you, God, for healing. Healing, oh God. Healing, oh God. Healing, oh God. Healing. Ooh. Like a river, God. Let your healing flood our hearts. Let your healing flood our minds. Let your healing flood our souls. Let your healing flood our bodies. Let your healing, oh God, just come on in. Let your healing just come into every fiber of our being. God, we bless you. You are a healer, oh God. You're a healer. You are the one that heals. You are the one that sets free. You know why the Lord is concerned about our healing? Because just like that man, he was stuck at a place because he needed something. He needed healing. He needed to his legs to be restored. He needed to be healed in order to get up and walk forward in life. And the Lord is concerned about anything that has you at a place of stagnation. Thank you for healing Pastor Sonia. God, I thank you for healing her. Oh, we honor you, we honor you, we honor you, God, we honor you. Oh, God, that's right, Nanny. Thank him for opening your eyes. Yes, God. Ah, glory, glory. We pray, oh God, for Key Kai. I don't know how to say it, but God, we lift her up, God, or him up, Lord. Heal in the name of Jesus. Heal in the name of Jesus. Heal in the name of Jesus. Oh God. Heal, Lord Jesus. Oh, we thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you. We thank you, Lord Jesus. We pray, oh God, for Shakia and James and Kwame. Heal in Jesus' name. Heal, oh God, thank you. Led to pray for adolescent diabetes. Oh God, for all those children, God, that are pre-diabetic and even those who have been diagnosed with diabetes. We ask, oh God, for healing to come into their lives. God, that you would heal and restore their bodies to proper functioning in Jesus' name. Some of us have children who are on that verge, to either diagnosed or going to be diagnosed with diabetes. We pray healing. God, we pray reversal. Reversal, 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 reversal in Jesus' name. Reversal. God, that the glucose levels in their bodies will level out. We pray reversal. Any damage that has been done in their body to kidneys and organs, we pray reversal. We pray restoration in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. We pray restoration in Jesus' name. Restoration in Jesus' name. Woo. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Janet just sent a message that she was told that she's pre-diabetic. God, we pray for all those who've been told that they're on that verge, not just the children, but all those who've been told they're on the verge of being. Ooh, we pray healing in Jesus' name. Healing in Jesus' name. Healing in Jesus' name. I thank you, God, that you are giving discipline, that you will give discipline to Shana, God, to change her diet, to change her lifestyle. I thank you, God, for doing it even now in this time of healing. And that which she said is hard or impossible to do, God, I thank you for the grace to do it, God, that she will not have diabetes. We thank you, Lord. We thank you for reversal. You're reversing some things, God. We thank you. We thank you. That's right. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. For remission of cancer for children who are dealing with it. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, for remission of cancer, children and adults. We thank you for testimonies of reversing the cancer. We thank you for testimonies of reversing the damage. Oh my God. God, we thank you for reversal. God, we thank you for restoring life. We thank you, God. We thank you, God, for those even who are battling kidney disease. We thank you for restoration. Oh, God, we're bold enough to ask, oh, God, that you do a miracle and that, God, you give them new kidneys, Lord. We bless your name, God. We bless your name, God. We thank you, God. Someone put in the chat, Daybreak Women. Let's pray for all Daybreak Women. We lift, God, every woman that participates in this ministry. And God, we pray that every area of her life would experience her healing touch. That any area out of whack be healed in Jesus' name, my God. God, that you would heal her, God, physically. You would heal her emotionally. God, you would heal her relationally. God, you would even heal in her finances. God, you would heal, God, in her mind. God, you would heal in her soul. God, that you would heal from every wound, oh God, from every offense. God, that you would heal every single thing concerning her. God, we thank you for wholeness, wholeness. Wholeness in the life of every woman connected to Daybreak Woman. We thank you for wholeness, God, not just for her, but every man that is connected to her. We thank you for wholeness. We thank you for healing, oh God. Oh God, we bless you. We thank you for every marriage represented amongst those women. We thank you for wholeness in those marriages. We thank you for restoration, my God, in those marriages. We thank you for healing, oh God, everything concerning her. Everything that's out of whack, we call it into alignment in Jesus' name. Everything that's not cooperating, we call it into alignment in Jesus' name. Everything in our heart, we call it into alignment in Jesus' name. We call it into alignment, my God, we bless you. Peace is her portion. The joy of the Lord is her strength. Your glory, oh God, is her covering. Your grace, oh God, is new every day. Morning by morning, she experienced your mercies. I thank you, God, for equipping her, for enabling her, God, for giving her everything that she needs to do your will. She will not be bound by fear. She will not be bound by anxiety or panic attacks. She won't be bound by any of those things, but God, she's walking in your freedom. She's loving in your freedom. She's serving in your freedom. She's giving in your freedom, oh God. And her heart is open, God, to receive everything that you have for her, my God. I thank you. I thank you, God, that you're maturing her, God, not to no longer lean to her own wants, but to grab hold of your will for her life. I thank you, God, for maturity in that area, my God. Oh, God, I thank you that every woman who participates in Daybreak Woman is healed in Jesus' name. Healed in Jesus' name. Healing of the Lord overtake her life. Healing of the Lord overtake her life. God, we thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you. We thank you, God. We thank you. We thank you, God, for your healing power. You can keep throwing out those names. That's right. We lift up Pastor Cansado here. Heal, oh God. Heal. Heal. Oh God, heal, heal, heal. Even people we know, God, that are still dealing with COVID, those who are in the hospital dealing with COVID, we lift them up. We lift them up to you, God. Heal in Jesus' name. We honor you. We honor you, God. Oh, glory to your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. I want to pray for this pastor as battling COVID. He's in the hospital on a ventilator. His name is Pastor Adelson. As I was looking for his name, Pastor Adelson Henry Claude, Haitian pastor, Pastor Adelson Henry Claude. So Father, we lift him up to you on this night. As we pray for healing, God, we pray that you would touch him in his body. God, that you would drive out all traces of that virus. And God, that you would bring complete restoration into his body. God, we pray, Lord, that you would cause his lungs to be restored and healed in Jesus' name. God, that you would strengthen his lungs. God, that you would flush out all excess fluid from his body. God, that you would cause for his white blood cells, oh God, to fight and his red blood cells to do what it's supposed to do. God, we pray that you would cause every component of his body to function, oh God, as it should, God. When the disease enters in, God, that it would fight back, oh God. We pray, Lord, for strength to come into his body. And that the blood of Jesus, God, would cleanse him of all infirmity. The blood of Jesus would cleanse him of all infirmity. God, we thank you, Lord, for you are encamped round about him. And God, we thank you, God, for transformation, for healing, and for turning things around. Reverse, oh God, damage that has been done. Reverse the course of this virus in Jesus' name. God, we ask that you do it. We ask that you touch. And God, not just him, but God, others, God, that are still dealing with COVID. God, we pray healing. God, we pray healing. We pray healing. Even those, God, I see every day that are hospitalized with COVID. Heal in Jesus' name. Heal in Jesus' name. God, we present them before you. God, even those who don't know you, God, we pray that you would heal, that you would cause them to come to know you, God. Have mercy upon their souls and heal. We pray for Cassandra, God, heal in Jesus' name. That's right, God, we pray that you would heal us, oh God, that we would see. God, that we can do what you have called us to do. That's right. That we would know, oh God, heal us from all insecurity. Heal us from any negative image of ourselves. Heal us, oh God, from any negative thoughts that we have concerning ourselves. Heal us from low self-esteem. Heal us, oh God, in Jesus' name. Cause for confidence to rise up in us. Cause for courage to rise up in us. Cause for boldness, oh God, to rise up in us. Cause for it to rise up on the inside. Yes, yes. People have lost their jobs. Thank you, God. People lost jobs. People can't get employment. Ah, God, heal. Oh, there's so many in depression, so many in sorrow, so many, oh God, that are discouraged. God, we pray that you would heal them, God. Heal their hearts, and that you would meet their every need. God, that you would provide, you would supply all of their needs according to your riches and glory. And God, even if there's any amongst us right now, God, who lost their jobs, and they're searching and they can't find anything, God, that you would make a way out of no way. You can do anything, God. Move people out and move people in. According to thy will. Let your favor be upon your people. Let your favor be upon your people. Let your favor be upon your people, God. Oh, God. Oh, breathe, breath of God. Breathe. Breathe on your people and refresh. Breathe on your people and refresh, God. Breathe on your people and refresh, oh God. Breathe on your people and refresh, God. We thank you. Yeah, God, Ramas. We continue to pray, God, for those frontline workers, those essential workers, God, heal. Those who worked so much since last year, God, and they're worn out and they're tired, God. Send restoration, God. Bless them, oh God. Strengthen them, oh God. Strengthen, God, those amongst us, oh God. Strengthen, God, in Jesus' name. Strengthen, God, in Jesus' name. Oh, we thank you, Lord. We thank you, God, that you are a healer. We've been waiting on some things, God. But we thank you that healing is here because the healer is here. We thank you. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for being the God who sees and the God who knows. And the God who blesses us and keeps us and takes care of us. You take care of us, and we're so grateful. We're so grateful, God. Oh, it's funny. We're closing out, and this song just came on. Never lost a battle. It's appropriate, it's fitting as we close out tonight. Remember, that's right. He never sleeps nor slumber.
Sing it as loud as you can, all nations.
My God has never lost a battle. Broken the curse. He's never lost a battle. Hear that? Jesus? Our God will never, ever, 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 ever lose a battle. And so I want to thank you tonight for joining us for this time of prayer, this time of just crying out and interceding, so much happening around us in our lives and the lives of people that we know and we love. I want to encourage you to keep on praying, to keep on trusting the Lord, and to walk knowing that the healer is here. He's here. He's here. And he comes with everything that you need. And so thank you so much. If you are watching, if you've been watching for the first time, make sure you text the word daybreak to 77948 so that you can get notifications. Text the word daybreak to the number 77948. We're here every Thursday at 9:30 p.m. and Tuesday mornings at 6:30 a.m. We're on Zoom mainly. And so text so that you can get that dial-in information that we could continue to grow together, seek God together. And if you've been blessed in this time of prayer, do me a favor, like the video, heart the video, whichever you desire to do, and share it with someone else that they may be encouraged that the God who heals is right here. God bless you and have a wonderful, wonderful rest of the night. Thank you so much. Thank you, Nanny. Thank you, Maria. Thank you, Dorothy. Thank you, Nancy, Shayna, Bobby, Jackie, Lydia, Marcel, Rhonda. Thank you, Carolyn. Thank you so much for all those who came on, all those, even those who didn't say anything. But you were on. So I don't know if you were on because you didn't say anything, but God bless you. Love you. Thank you, Ari, for jumping on. Go back, watch it, share it with someone. Be a blessing to someone.